So be honest, are you paying too much for cable and internet service? Hey, what's going on? My name's Michael and I run the personal finance website, michaelsaves.com. And in this video, I'm gonna share three ways to help you lower your Comcast bill right away. The first way to lower your cable and internet bill is to downgrade to limited basic. Now, this isn't the cable package you're used to with more than 100 channels. In fact, limited basic, you only get your local stations that you would normally get with an antenna and maybe a premium channel such as HBO. The benefit of this is that you still get your internet service bundled. For some reason, when I called Comcast and said, look, I just want internet only, they said it was cheaper for me to keep limited basic and my regular internet service. So what I did is I added a live TV streaming service because that limited basic really just wasn't enough for me. I've reviewed all the live TV streaming services and my favorite is Hulu with live TV, YouTube TV, Sling TV, DirecTV Now. There are a few of the other popular options. If you tried any of them out, leave a comment below and let me know which one is your favorite. But while you have your regular cable package, you can take advantage of the free trials for all the live TV streaming services and then pick a favorite and downgrade to limited basic cable. Next, eliminate monthly equipment fees. And what I'm talking about is the $13 a month wireless gateway charge. If you have internet with Xfinity, you're probably paying this if you rent a modem router combo from Comcast. What you can do is you can go to Comcast's website. They have a list of approved devices, buy your own router modem combo, swap it out, and then you stop paying $13 a month. I just did this recently and it's nice to see that $13 a month deducted from my bill. The one that I bought is a Motorola brand device. It cost only $100. So for $100, a one-time fee, I eliminated that $13 a month charge. The third and final way to lower your Comcast bill is to contact customer service and ask for a lower rate. It's not really asking, it's more of negotiating, and Comcast is used to this. They get these calls all the time. What you do is you go online and find a better offer from a competitor. I have Comcast, so in my case, the competitor is AT&T. I go to their website and see what they're offering for internet and TV service. Then I'll call Comcast 1-800-XFINITY and ask for the customer solutions department. That's the retention department. When you're connected to them, just present the offer from AT&T and ask them if there's anything they can do to work with you on the monthly price, because you want to let them know that you're not happy with what you're paying and you need to lower your monthly bill. Usually they come back with something and it may require that you get a little bit of a slower internet or move to a package that you haven't heard of, but you can decide how far you want to take it with them and how long you want to negotiate. I usually get my rate extended for a year and then mark it on my calendar to call back and start the negotiation all over again the next year. If this is too much work for you, there's another service called Ask Trim. They do the work for you, but they take a 33% cut of the savings. So I think it's worth it for you to give it a try on your own and see what happens.